when a person has a blunt spinal cord injury, the general wisdom as to the science or the biology behind it is that there are some nerves that are lost for good, so they're severed. There's a number of nerves, however, that are not lost, they're not beyond repair, but they're stunned. So what the AST-OPC1 does is re-insulate the nerves that have lost insulation in a functionally relevant manner.
When you talk to these patients, they describe a process of their sensation and their function returning in a stepwise fashion, beginning close to their body, what we call proximally, and then working its way out in their arms, for example, down to their hands.
Lucas was a quadriplegic, complete quadriplegic, which means he had no function of any kind below the level of injury in his mid to lower cervical spinal cord. So he had the most severe kind of spinal cord injury possible.
Well, I was pretty skeptical after the accident. That was not a good time. Pretty skeptical on being able to do anything, pretty skeptical on what was gonna happen, pretty skeptical on everything.
I remember watching that lady do the pin test and ask where he could feel stuff, and he never felt it. She would go, you know, all over trying to get him to say that he could feel something. And that was one of the hardest things for me to watch.
Right.
Keep hoping that the next one you'll feel, and he didn't. After we got the surgery for the AST-OPC1, that's when we got encouragement. And we're seeing it. We're seeing the signs. We're seeing Luke heal. It's been great.
To, you know, regain hand function alone gives me everything that I've ever needed or wanted back.
I saw him use a smartphone. I saw him email. I saw him grasp my hands, my fingers, and squeeze with significant strength on both sides. You have to remember that this is a person that had no use at all of his hands.
And it's still, you know, at that progress level, where just recently I was able to touch, you know, my pinky to thumb, which I wasn't able to do that 3 months ago, even. So yeah, this is huge.
And I can see him getting off on his own and living by himself and taking care of himself. Before the surgery, I don't think that could possibly have happened. I think he would have been dependent on somebody forever. And he's going to have his independence.
I cannot tell you how encouraged I am based on what I've been hearing and seeing, not only with Lucas, but others like him who've gone through AST-OPC1's trial.